My name is Ashok Guru. I'm the director of India China Institute. And I'm really delighted to welcome all of you to this special, I would say, conversation, get together, and also an occasion to celebrate and partly to learn from, you know, what some of our grant recipients, student grant recipients, have used a bit of resources that the Institute was able to provide as student grants have done during their summer explorations in India and China. So really, today is about what, you know, New School is all about. That is to really to engage with students, to support what students are here for in terms of, you know, both, you know, advancing and pursuing their formal degree as well as learning in a broader sense of the word. So I think I'm happy that many of you have decided to come and be with us this afternoon. And I know that many of you are here also to learn a bit more about India-China Institute, both, you know, in terms of the kind of work we do and the kind of support we provide. So I want to talk about that. So let me just quickly go over a bit about, you know, who we are, what we do, and how you can get involved with us. And then after that, I'll ask our grant recipients, students, to talk a bit about their work. I know that they can talk for a long time because they had such an amazing experience, but we have asked them to just give a bit of a, you know, a teaser, glimpse into what they did during the summer. Okay, I think as most of you probably know, we are a unique entity within the New School. It's one of the very few entities that really is truly university-wide initiative. We are not part of any department or school. We are a university-wide, you know, center. That means we deliberately look for and welcome engagement of students and faculty members from every part of the university. So this is something that, you know, we are very proud of, and we want this to continue to grow. We were established in 2005. Our really very, you know, primary, I would say, purpose is to look at India-China both historically and from a contemporary point of view, look at how this amazing story that is developing, you know, in the 21st century, and what can we learn from, you know, engaging with India-China story, what can we contribute towards that, and how can we apply that, even if you are sitting in Latin America or Africa or in the US. So I think that's, broadly speaking, is what our primary focus is. It's centered around supporting teaching, research, and, you know, building of networks, building up a community of scholars who are interested in this story. Okay, it's unique in the sense that there are many centers of similar nature in major universities in the US, but what makes our center very unique is, for the first time in higher education, we are looking at India, China, US together. We recently heard that Stanford University has also decided to establish a center called China India Institute, I guess, you know. So someone is following us a little bit. But I think that's unique in the sense because it directly challenges the earlier notions of how you study different parts of the world. There was a concept developed in early, you know, 60s, partly supported by an entity like Ford Foundation, where I used to work many years ago, under the this idea of area studies. That means you carve out different parts of the world, Central America, South Asia, and you develop scholarship. So departments, centers are created around those, you know, ideas. And what that did, when it comes to India-China, we share almost 4,000 kilometers of border, that these two countries were never studied together, right? So New School, you know, despite its challenges, and decided to really challenge that and look at India-China together in relation to, you know, US, right? So in terms of intellectual frame, we basically are interested in three large intellectual frames. One is what can we learn by focusing on India-China interactions, both historically and in contemporary context. Second is the comparative frame, right? By comparing the two countries, especially, you know, if you think about, let's say, poverty alleviation or environmental issues, even though these two countries have very different systems, what can we learn by looking at their experience, both positive and negative ones? Okay. The third storyline that we're interested in is the joint impact of reemergence of India-China on Africa, or in Africa, right? Or Latin America, or US, Europe, on its neighbors. So I think those are the storylines we are following, and in that mix, students, of course, are very central to us because we are part of the university, and a lot of our faculty members, and here I want to thank some of our faculty, you know, colleagues who are here, faculty advisors, I know Leiping is here, who really are engaged in this very, you know, modest but very important effort to really think about their own research, to think about their teaching, and also helping us expand the networks with, you know, various universities and think tanks in India and China. Okay. So here you will see three of us, and Grace is sitting here, ICI office manager, Grace.
Yeah.
Many of you know her. Grace actually runs the place. She definitely makes me run. And we have Mark Frazier, who is unfortunately, he could not join us today, but if you are interested in a China story, he is one of the leading scholars who has done quite a bit of work on labor issues and looking at urban space in China. So I think in regard to students, what do we offer? How can we get you engaged or more engaged? I think we obviously have student research grants. These are, small grants, $3,000, but I think they are important, and you will soon hear from five grant recipients what they did with this modest, but I think, I hope, the timely contribution. There's a program under Emerging Scholars Symposium. We do have, several volunteer as well as, research assistant opportunities at the Institute. Many of you have worked with us. And each semester we do have a few openings, so I would say, stay engaged. And if you're interested in, send us your resume and talk to us. Through the Institute, as I said, when we offer a lot of, or we support a lot of courses that are taught by various colleagues. So if you're interested in India-China story and you want to find out what kind of courses are offered, you can go to our website and learn more about them. Next semester, I'll be teaching a course on Global Himalaya Rethinking Culture and Ecology. We have a project funded by Luce Foundation that really has enabled us to go deeper into looking at both the transnational dimension of how a place like China, India, and a small country like Nepal, relative to India and China, are struggling with this issue, questions of, how do you look at energy questions? How do you look at environmental questions? How do you look at ethics? So I think there are a number of similar courses that you could, find, okay, and benefit from. Our website, we believe, is becoming a really a good resource for many of you who are either writing a paper or want to, explore India-China in whatever ways, you wish to. So I would really encourage you, if you are writing on any aspect or anything related to India-China, to go to our website, because some of the most interesting thinkers, policymakers, leaders have gone through the Institute's public program, and they have given lectures. Many of their lectures are videotaped, so they are available on our site. As you know, when people write their books, it takes a long time, but here they come and they share their ideas as they are developing. So I would encourage you to check out our website. And of course, we organize a series of lectures, colloquiums, seminars, conferences, and I would encourage you to, if you haven't done it, sign up for our mailing list. That way, you will know what's happening. come to those events. I think a bit more on the student travel and research grant. The deadline has been extended. Now it's October 27th. I would really encourage each one of you, if you haven't done so, and if you qualify, to apply. Because even if you are, you know, not necessarily becoming an expert of India-China, I think we at the Institute like to argue that India-China's story is going to shape, you know, all of our lives. So take this opportunity, at least try, and go to India and China. We do give priority to people who are not experts on India-China. If you know India well, try to go to China. If you know China well, try to go to India. Okay, so that's the spirit behind, you know, this particular grant. I think one key thing you need in order to really be eligible, besides writing a good essay, is find a faculty member who you tell about your ideas, and someone has to support, at least in principle, that they will oversee your project. That's very important because we want faculty members to know that you are thinking about India-China in a certain way and you need their support. So I hope many of you will apply, and after everyone has spoken, if you have any more specific questions, we can try to respond to them. I think all of this detail regarding requirements and process is on our website, so go to our website. I've already talked about job opportunities, volunteer opportunities, and I think many of you know that at the New School there are many, many wonderful possibilities for volunteering and getting research assistantships. But working with us, we feel you will be part of a community of peers where we do attract people from different parts of the university, so you will go beyond your immediate network of school or program you're enrolled in. So that's very attractive to many of our research assistants and volunteers. I think it's a nice little community, so come and see us if you want to be involved in either as a volunteer or as a research assistant. These are some of the sample courses that are being either taught or will be taught during spring semester. I think I mentioned to you a bit about our website really is a resource. A lot of these talks are now on our website. In terms of upcoming events, these are some of the sample events that we will be hosting in the near future. Please, if you're schedule allows, come to these events. Okay, I think that's a brief kind of an overview. I think at this point what I would like to do is go right into our hearing from our students. Each one of you, please take 5 minutes. I know you have much longer and much more interesting story to tell, but I think today let's limit it to 5 minutes each, and then we will go into Q&A. We will take about 10, 15 minutes to just respond to your questions, either to them or to me. And then we want to hang around. I think hopefully there's still some food left, some drinks left. And feel free to just get up and get something, from the table. And keep listening and keep engaging. Okay.